Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hello, my name is Skylar. I am a certified dog trainer and pet nutritionist. Today we are going to be doing a super highly requested video. We're gonna be reviewing Farmina Pet Foods. So for our deep dive today, we're going to be looking at two different dog food flavors, a cat flavor, and then another cat flavor that's one of their specialty lines. Farmina is one of those brands that does have a couple different formulas that are specific to like sensitive skin, digestion. Today we're going to be looking at the urinary formula for cat. And I have a lot of thoughts and opinions about these particular formulas, so we'll get to those later in the video. They also have a vet life line that is not something that we're going to be getting into today. I thought about including it in this video, but after taking one look at those ingredient panels, it immediately made me very concerned. So that will probably be included in another video down the line when I talk specifically just about vet foods and my professional opinions on them. Without further ado, let's go ahead and we'll get into the video. I'm gonna apologize now because I have a feeling I'm gonna butcher this name. Farmina was actually started by the Russo Magnemi Company, which was founded back in 1965, but they didn't actually start focusing on pet food production until his son took it over in 1999. Their primary focus up until this point was more on the medical side of pet nutrition. And then again, once that son took it over in 1999, they switched their focus more to pet food. Farmina is made in Italy, which means that not only are they following our standards here in the US, but they actually have to follow the even higher standards of the EU. Every country and every region has their own rules and regulations when it comes to pet food, people food, how their food is grown, raised, slaughtered, all that kind of stuff. So taking into consideration where these pet foods are made can tell us a lot about the quality of the foods. So the quality of Farmina and their ingredients are really, really great. Farmina only uses natural preservatives, which you know we love. Those are the, when you see mixed tocopherols on an ingredient panel, that is a natural preservative made of antioxidants. They are GMO free in all of their ingredients, so made in Italy, which as we mentioned before, has a higher standard of production than we have here in the US. They also are completely corn, wheat, soy, and byproduct free, which we love. And it's also a low glycemic index ingredients, which means that it's not going to cause those big spikes in blood sugar, which makes this a pretty good food for if your pet has diabetes. So the very first formula that we're gonna look into is a dog food. This one is the ancient grain chicken pomegranate adult food. So the very first thing that I always look at when I'm looking at a feed bag is the way that things are worded. So there's a ton of different rules and regulations to even what's on the bag, how big it is, what fonts they can be in, how big those fonts can be. So just by looking at even how they describe their flavor can tell you a lot about what's actually in the bag. So this one is a chicken, spelt, oat, and pomegranate recipe. So when we see recipe, we know that it has to follow the 25% rule, which means that all of those ingredients listed before recipe have to combined make up at least 25% of the food, and no ingredient can make up less than 3%. They can absolutely go higher than that 25%, but knowing these boundaries lets us know how much of these ingredients are really actually in the food. Looking at this ingredient panel, we know that salt is usually 1 to 2% of the formula, so we kind of disregard everything after salt for the most part. And then the first 5 ingredients makes up the majority of the pet food in most cases. So in this particular formula, we have boneless chicken, dehydrated chicken, whole spelt, whole oat, and chicken fat as our first 5 ingredients. We also have dried whole eggs. I love seeing whole eggs if you see egg product. That one's kind of a sketchy alternative. But if it's whole egg, we know that it's the whole egg and all of the nutrients that go along with that. So that's, we like to see that. We also have herring, dehydrated herring, and herring oil. So these ones, I personally always appreciate when an actual fish is added to the formula rather than a fish oil. Fish oils themselves are very temperamental. They're the drama queens of the pet food label. And so keeping them actually functioning as they should be is near impossible in dry foods. That's why a lot of people recommend adding in supplementally a fish oil or some other source of omega-3s and 6s. So actually adding in the herring, the dehydrated herring, is the preferred way, in my personal opinion. Further down in this ingredient panel is when we actually see the pomegranate. And that's totally normal. And a lot of pet food brands, including when we look at this one's label, we see the chicken, the spelt, and the oats, and those are typically towards the front of the panel. But sometimes they like to throw a little fruit or veggie in there just to spice things up. Just be like, hey, look at me, we have fruits and veggies. Which is totally valid. It's within their right. They're still not breaking any laws there. But we can assume the dried pomegranate that we see is gonna be towards that 3% of the formula that's required in that 25% rule. I have also went ahead and just included the super simple breakdown of the protein, the fat, and the fiber. I also went ahead and included the carbohydrate count there at the bottom as well, just based off of the simple math that was available. So it's not gonna be spot on, but it's gonna be pretty dang close. Dog food manufacturers, cat food manufacturers, pet food manufacturers in general are not required to include the carbohydrate count, and that's entirely to their benefit. In a couple videos already, we've talked about kind of the correct carbohydrate count, how much carbohydrates your dog or cat should be consuming. If you're looking at the primordial diet, which is based off what their ancestors would be eating and what biologically they should be eating, it's one of the couple different models that kind of break that down. For cats, they estimate between 2 and 5% carbohydrate, and for dogs, they estimate between usually 12 and 15%. And again, in the wild, those percentages would primarily come from whatever their kill ate. So we wanna try to get as close to that as possible. In general, we over-carbohydrate our animals when we feed them kibble. So I do include the carbohydrate count there for you, just so you can kind of compare. What's nice about this formula though is 90% of the protein does come from an animal source. Some people get very confused looking at numbers like this one, just because it says 90% from animal sources, and then you kind of start picking out like, oh, protein, blah, 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 blah. And a lot of people will look at this bag and say, oh, 90% of that bag is meat. And that's not the case. 90% of that 30% that we looked at comes from animals and not from plant sources, which is awesome. Still great. Just all those little things need to be aware of when you're looking at pet food. So our second dog food that we're going to be taking a look at is the grain-free prime lamb and blueberry adult formula. Looking at the front of this bag, it is a lamb and blueberry recipe, which again follows our 25% rule, meaning that at least 25% of the food has to be made up of lamb and blueberry with a minimum of 3% for each ingredient. The first five of the ingredient panel, we have lamb, dehydrated lamb, sweet potatoes, dried whole eggs, and we have herring. So again, pretty good first five ingredients. I'm not mad about that. Sweet potatoes are excellent, way better than a white potato. When you just see potato, you can assume it's a white potato. White potatoes in general, really high in starch, really high in sugars, and can help to exacerbate yeast, and can ultimately just cause a lot of issues within the dog's body microbiome. So I much prefer sweet potatoes. And then we already talked about the benefits of the dried whole egg. If you look further down on this ingredient panel, we do see the dried blueberry. So since it is so far down, we can assume that it makes up the 3% of the formula based on the rules of the 25% rule. With this one as well, I included the carbohydrate count. And this one does have 98% of protein from animal sources. You might be asking yourself, all right, this one, the grain-free, has 98% protein from animal sources. The last one we looked at only had 90%. Why is this? Well, certain grains, legumes, other ingredients do also add to the protein count. Whether they're added to the formula because they add protein count or not is something that you kind of need to look into. So this one here, looking at it, we can tell these ingredients were not added to up the protein. They just happened to add to the protein. A lot of grocery store foods where you see a whole lot of pea, especially pea protein listed in the ingredient panel, do add these plant proteins just so they can meet the minimum protein requirement for AFCO. And those are the ones that you want to be aware of and kind of steer clear of. Moving right along, we have our very first cat food. This one is the grain-free ocean herring and orange adult food. So again, we're looking at the front of this bag. It is the herring and orange recipe. So again, a 25% rule. I'm sure you know what a 25% rule is at this point, so I'm not going to go and explain that. Our first five ingredients, we have herring, dehydrated herring, sweet potato, herring oil, and dried whole eggs. We also have pea fiber that's popped up in all of these ingredients. I just want to point this out now. The pea fiber is just there to add fiber. It's not going to be there to add protein. Fiber is very important in the dog food to just kind of keep things running smoothly. And even again in the wild, our dogs and cats would be eating things like hair that would help push things through and create that fiber content. So obviously it's a herring and orange formula. We have herring as the first ingredient. And then further down this ingredient panel, we have the sweet orange. And again, it's nice that it's there and it's good to kind of have that as a reference of, okay, we know that's about 3% of the formula and we know salt's about 2%. So we can kind of figure things out in between there. But it's more for the consumer to be like, hey, there's fruit. Again, I have the general breakdown of percentages, including the carbohydrates. You'll notice that the protein count on the cat food is higher than the dog food. There is a very big difference between dog and cat food, and you should not be feeding your dog cat food and your cat dog food. If they do it from time to time, it's not gonna kill them, but it is, they have different nutritional needs, and I can do a whole video on that later. But cats do require a higher percentage of protein, and this particular food does have 98% of their protein source coming from animals, which is exactly what you want with cats, especially. All right, so for our fourth food, we're looking at a specialized food. This one is the quinoa adult cat food, specifically for urinary. Before we get into this particular recipe, I do want to make a little note here. I, in general, am not a huge fan of specialized diets. I'm not even going to go into the vet side of things. I'm not going to go into vet foods, just specialized diets in general. Even like the senior formula or the weight management formula. I don't like them. I don't, for the most part. Just because what they're offering typically can be found in other formulas. For example, weight management foods, they'll typically up the carbohydrate and lower the protein. In theory, it's supposed to make your dog feel fuller longer. The reality is they need the protein and the fat to like process the food. So what you should be doing instead is sticking with your regular food, feeding less of it. And it would be even better if you added a canned food, raw food, cooked meat, whatever on top of it to then make it even easier to digest and to lower the carbohydrate. Someone's coming up the stairs. With that said, the specialized foods from Farmina that we're going to look at are actually pretty decent, and they do offer some benefits that we will talk about. All right, so we're looking at the urinary formula for cat. This one is duck, quinoa, cranberry, and chamomile recipe. So again, using that 25% rule, all four of those ingredients have to make up at least 25% of the recipe, and no ingredient can be less than 3%. So, first five ingredients, we have boneless duck, dehydrated duck, pea starch, chicken fat, and quinoa seed. I'm not the biggest fan of the pea starch, but I do know that it's a limited ingredient food and you do need a binder, and that's what that pea starch is there for. So I'm not going to dox them for that necessarily. And then looking further down, we have dried cranberry and chamomile. So what I do really appreciate about this formula is that they do include cranberry and chamomile. So both of these do help with urinary problems. Cranberries add a lot of antioxidants to the food, and it's those antioxidants that are going to kind of help clean things up. Just like if you yourself have a UTI, you typically hear a lot of people recommending to drink cranberry juice. It's that same concept. We also have chamomile in here, which is said to increase antibacterial activity, which again, for a bacterial infection like a UTI or a urinary tract infection, is can be really, really beneficial in helping to prevent that. Are there better ways of preventing urinary tract issues in cats than by feeding a dry kibble? Absolutely. In fact, most kidney issues and urinary tract issues found in cats are because they're only fed kibble. So just a friendly reminder, feed your cats and your dogs as much meat and moisture as you can possibly afford. But with that said, this particular formula is not as bad as I was afraid that it potentially could be. So if you're feeding this, if it's working for you, awesome. But again, definitely add as much moisture and meat in there as possible. And like I said, I'm not gonna even go into their Vet Life formula. If you're feeding it, I recommend maybe switching on to something from one of their more traditional formulas, just because I'm, again, a whole video for further down the road. Ultimately, I really like Farmina. I think they're a great company. I do have a little bit of a reserve. They are building a kitchen here in the US. And as we saw from Origin and Akena, when they moved from Canada to the US, that kind of started a snowball effect from them. So this is definitely a brand I'll be keeping an eye on. But ultimately, looking at it right now and the way it is, I'm a huge fan of Farmina, especially if you're wanting to feed a grain-inclusive food. They have a lot of really good options. And I do appreciate, even though I can be a little bit of a critic, I do really appreciate that they include fruits and vegetables and that kind of stuff in their recipe name, just because it does guarantee that it's not just there at the end of the ingredient panel for fun. So it's actually like, there's enough in there to do something. A ton of you guys have requested that I do a deep dive on Farmina. You want my opinions on Farmina. And I hope that you got some information, some of my opinions in here. If you have any other pet food companies that you would like me to do a deep dive review on, definitely leave those down in the comments. And if I see it a whole bunch of times, trust me, it bumps right up to the top of my list, just as this one did. So if you learned something, definitely leave a comment, leave a like, and subscribe to my channel. I make Training Tuesday and Feeding Friday videos every single week, so you have a good mix of behavior and training, as well as nutritional information and advice. So if you are a pet owner, this is a great channel for you. You're gonna get a whole bunch of information. With that said, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.